Hi friends, I am Venicia, and in this video, I'm going to be talking all about cyber threat intelligence, share some helpful tips on how you can become a cyber threat intelligence analyst, and some training options for you to consider. Welcome to my channel, where we talk all about cybersecurity and how you can succeed as a woman in cybersecurity. If you are looking to learn all about threat intelligence, then this is the video for you. So before we get started, as always, let's look at your cybersecurity tip of the week. And this week, I want you to consider whether you have ever checked, or when last you've checked, if you have been impacted in a security breach or compromise. And how you can do this is by going to haveibeenpwned.com, and I will leave the link in the description, and you type in your email address and you can see if your data has been compromised in a known data compromise. And if it is listed there, then what you want to do is go to all of those accounts. Firstly, evaluate if they're still relevant or if you need to close them down. And if they are relevant, then change all your passwords and, of course, enable multi-factor authentication. All right, so this video is part of a video series where I'm actually breaking down the different domains within cybersecurity, making it easier for you to be able to evaluate what you want to do in your career. So if you haven't checked out the other videos in the series, I will link it up in the cards or at the end of this video for you to go and check it out. As always, if you find this content helpful, please remember to give it a like, comment, subscribe to help my channel out. So let's start with understanding what cyber threat intelligence actually is. And this is simply the information about cyber threats, cyber crime, things that attribute to cyber crime, indicators, behaviors, etc. A whole bunch of information and information components that we can analyze, contextualize, and understand to be able to help an organization to make key strategic and informed decisions about their cyber defense strategy. So cyber threat intelligence is a critical component to any organization because it helps with those early warning signs, it helps contextualize potential threats against that organization so that the organization can put in place a robust and informed cyber defense strategy. Any threat intelligence strategy actually has four notable sections or components to it, and this would be firstly tactical and technical intelligence, operational intelligence, and then strategic intelligence. Now, if we look at the tactical and technical intelligence components, these components are mainly already today, it's already automated, it's already in systems, in feeds. If you have a firewall in your organization, you're likely already subscribing to that vendor's feed of threat intelligence, and that would typically contain known indicators of compromise, such as IP addresses, malicious domain names, malicious file hashes, etc., that you would be able to put the relevant access controls and rules in place to block that type of activity. And here, the tactical and technical components typically is heavily machine dependent and heavily automated, and there's very little human intervention on that, in that component of the threat intel strategy. Then looking at the operational threat intelligence components, so here what we're really trying to do is we're trying to understand who these threat actors are. That is called attribution. We're trying to understand what they're doing, and we're trying to understand why they do what they do. And so that is really the understanding the intent of different threat actor groups. And we also try then to understand what their MO is. So what is their modus operandi? What is their way of operating? That's what we call the TTPs, which is the common tactics, techniques, and procedures that different threat actor groups use to actually infiltrate or target an organization or a victim. And by understanding this, we as the cyber defenders can really become familiar with the different cyber criminal groups, threat actor groups, how they behave, what they do, what their typical common targets are, etc. And we can then be able to, based on that behavior, make more informed decisions on how likely a cyber criminal group is able to, you know, target our particular organization. If there's a criminal group that specifically we know that they target the financial services industry and you're a financial services organization, then typically you want to put them higher on the list to protect yourselves against those known tactics, techniques, and procedures, TTPs. So here we really require a lot more of the human intervention of this, for humans to actually understand, you know, what we've seen from an indicator perspective, where else we've seen these indicators, and how we then attribute these various indicators and the various methods of attack to different criminal groups. And so there, it's a combination of, you know, the machine and the automated intelligence, as well as the human intervention from an intelligence perspective and analysis and reporting on those cyber criminal groups, etc. Now, the last component here is the strategic threat intelligence component. And this is the hardest form of intelligence to actually gather information on, to actually try and understand how this intelligence or this form of intelligence can be associated with your business specifically. And it is not something that can be said with absolute certainty. It is something that's very uncertain. For example, from a strategic intelligence perspective, we would want to understand how political events in the world, financial markets, longer term industry events would impact our organization from a cyber crime and cyber criminal perspective. So that's what we're trying to understand with strategic intelligence. And here it's most of the time, mostly human analysis that takes place on this layer, because we have to have people that understand these different components, the different markets, and understand how this can potentially result in cybercrime against our organization. All right, who is a cyber threat intelligence analyst and what do they do? So a threat intel analyst is someone that gathers external and internal information about potential threat data and is able to contextualize that information back to a business. The information needs to be actionable, and actionable is such a critical word in the world of threat intelligence, because it must be information that the organization can do something about. It's different to a SOC analyst, for example, where a SOC analyst would look at indicators that we've already detected in the system, would look at how we respond to those indicators and what we need to do further from there. A threat intelligence analyst understands the data from external threat sources, from internal threat sources, from global events that's happening, political events that's happening, cyber criminal groups changing their methods and their ways, etc. And we feed that information proactively into SOC teams, we make our businesses aware, and we basically contextualize this threat information or this new event data for anyone in the organization to be able to understand how this could potentially impact our organization in the future. A threat intel analyst needs to be skilled in the collection of information, analysis of information, monitoring, research, and really more on the softer skill side. So writing reports, creating documents, contextualizing information back to business stakeholders, meaning it needs to be translated from the common technical terms that we reference in the IT world to non-technical terms in the business world. And so it's really a well-rounded person that's required here. Sometimes there would be technical work involved, understanding, you know, how that malware perhaps operates. not having to reverse engineer the malware, not necessarily having coding skills or anything like that, but just understanding different types of malware, how it operates, etc. And sometimes when we go to more senior levels of threat engineers and threat intelligence specialists, then we would get into ourselves actually trying to reverse engineer something new that we found in our environment and seeing how we could then use that information of how we did what we detected to potentially be able to understand what that threat is and how that threat operates. Some of the common job titles in this field includes a cyber threat intelligence analyst, threat intelligence engineers, threat intel specialists. Sometimes we have the forensic people also double hatting into the threat intel space. We also have cyber threat researchers, and those are typically the more advanced guys, and you know, some of these guys trolling dark web and the underground forums to find new information about threats, etc. There are some great training options on Udemy, Coursera, and Cyberary. I've done some of the training on there myself. There are great options available. And then some more formal industry training is the Cyber Threat Intelligence Certification by SANS, as well as the Threat Intelligence Certification by EC Council, that you can explore if you are interested in a career in cyber threat intelligence. Alright friends, that is it for this video. I hope that you found it helpful and informative. All the links and resources referenced in the video will be linked in the description box below, so feel free to check that out. And I will catch you next time. Bye!